First of all, I had a lot of Jewish relatives who were my age, cousins and whatnot. They were all Jewish. Secondly, the district in which we lived was about half Jewish. And so I'm sure, so even though I don't remember specific ones, I'm sure that half my friends in the park were Jewish. And it, as I said, until the Nazis, the question of Jewish, not Jewish, at least at my age, was not much of an issue. We played with whoever we played with.
Did you experience any anti-Semitism in school?
Before the Nazi annexation of Austria, I do not have any recollections of anti-Semitism in school, even though certainly Austria was not a pro-Semitic country. And I'm sure I would have experienced it later. I mean, there were lots of things in Austria going on before the Nazis that were anti-Jewish. There were restrictions to the number of Jews who could go to the university, and all kinds of things I learned about later. But I don't recall. After the annexation, I certainly did experience anti-Semitism. I mean, we were ridiculed. People called us names. Kids, I mean. And I remember distinctly being told by my mother not to get into that if a, what we used to call, or what they called in those days, an Aryan child, which means a Gentile child, wanted some, never to get into a fight with an Aryan child because they were afraid of being denounced. They said, you know, whatever it is, your job is to say amen to whatever they ask. And I also remember, of course, very well, at this park that we've been talking about, one day there appeared this sign that said the Jews were no longer welcome in the park. That was a big thing for me because that was my second home, really. That's where I lived. And then, of course, this nanny that I keep talking about, German word for nanny is Teta, so that's what I called her, Teta. She had to leave us because there was no longer allowed for Jews to have Aryan servants. And that was something of a trauma for me that never quite understood because I was very, very close to her.